The first day of November, and more missiles rained down upon Ukraine's capital.
Russia launched dozens of cruise missiles at targets across the country. Authorities in Ukraine say 44 of the missiles were shot down by air defences, but the rest made it through, damaging critical infrastructure.
4 out of 5 residents in Kyiv have no power, no electricity, and temperatures are falling below zero. Kyiv's mayor said Russia was carrying out genocide.
I have a feeling the Russian aggressors want to freeze the people in this winter. They propose himself as war against military, but right now this war have directly impact in civil population.
Days later, and Russia would backtrack on its peace deal to allow Ukrainian grain to be shipped out via the Black Sea, meaning that food prices the world over would continue to climb. November 11, the day Ukraine's belief that they could win the war intensified.
Liberation videos like this are flooding social media, strengthening Ukraine's belief that it can win this war. Local villagers embrace their saviours, soldiers who raise their flag.
Слава Україні!
Героям слава!
Ukrainian troops pour into the city of Kherson, having forced the Russians to retreat. The strategically important southern port city was once home to 250,000 people and was one of the first to fall to Russian forces during the early days of the war. Just 6 weeks prior, Putin had declared the entire Kherson region was newly annexed Russian territory. But the Ukrainians fought back, forcing the 30,000 Russian troops into a hasty exit as they left behind ammunition and belongings. 5 days later, a breaking news story that shocked the world.
One of the two victims of that explosion in southeastern Poland farewelled today. A man remembered for sheltering Ukrainian refugees in the opening days of the invasion.
Polish investigators search for missile shrapnel in the hunt to discover who brought Europe to the brink.
Preliminary analysis suggests that the incident was likely caused by a Ukrainian air defense missile.
But Ukraine President Volodymyr Zelensky has surprised the West, refusing to accept blame. I have no doubt, he said, that it was not our missile. Polish authorities believe the shrapnel proves it was an S-300 Soviet-era rocket used by Ukraine. This is one successfully striking its target mid-air. But yesterday's missed and strayed into Polish territory.
Those innocent people would not have been killed if there had been no Russian war.
The end of the month saw Britain's new Prime Minister make his first visit to the capital. There, he announced a $90 million aid package for Ukraine, including anti-aircraft guns, just days after the heaviest airstrikes of the war so far.